So the real clinical problem is the problem of how to properly remove a tumour. Now, giving the example of breast cancer, which is a very common disease, it will affect more than 15,000 Australian women and over 100 Australian men this year. Around 25% of them, one in four patients, will have to come back for a second operation because the margins of the tumour were very close to the area that was removed. So really what we're trying to achieve is to come up with better, safer, more effective one-stop surgery. And that's clearly got huge benefits from the individual level. We know that clearly patients don't like to have to come back and have another operation, but it's more than they don't like it. We know they have worse outcomes. Then, of course, there's the cost both to the patient but also to the health system. When you consider breast cancer alone now affects 1.7 million women each year globally, that is an awful lot of people.
The goal is really to be able to put a tool in the hand of the surgeon so that they can get real-time in situ information which is superior to the information that they have now.
To have something that we can use in the operating theatre as a routine tool, much like we do with the scalpel or the gloves that we put on our fingers, that would help us distinguish tumour from normal tissue at a microscopic level.
So the technology that we work with is generally known as optical coherence tomography, and it actually gives you the capacity to see beneath the surface of what otherwise looks like opaque tissue. Sometimes we need to go deeper than that. So to address that challenge, we actually developed the microscope-in-a-needle technology.
So you feel the lump, you remove it, you hope all the edges are clean and don't have any tumour, but you don't know that.
Sometimes with the optical coherence tomography technology, we can't tell a difference between what is benign and what is malignant, and we want to see the border between the two. So we've been developing another technology known as optical elastography, which essentially tells the difference in the stiffness of the tissue. And we've shown that cancer has a particular hallmark, a particular signature, and that is that it causes this sort of soft, hard mixture. So we see that through a texture in the imaging that we do. Does that by pushing on the tissue and simultaneously capturing the image to see exactly how the tissue has moved, which actually provides her with higher sensitivity and even better resolution than you can get with your finger, microscopic resolution.
So if you could sweep your finger around inside, around the cavity, and make sure that there was no tumour left there, how nice would that be? And assure the patient when they wake up, we know all that tumour's gone, we know that there's none left behind in you. That would be a great goal.